Okay, so we're gonna do a little mixing for some color values. On this side, I've done the primary, pure hue, tint, shade, and tone, and the red and the blue. In here, I'm doing the secondary colors of the color wheel, and here I'm doing the tertiaries. I'm just gonna do a few, not too many, so I just wanna show you how I'm doing my mixing, so that you have a better idea of how to handle your paint and keep things clean. So I have lots of paper towel for wiping things off. I have my water. You want clean water. I have a big palette so that I can spread everything out. I've mixed for my tones where you mix gray into your pure hue on the color wheel. Remember, these are your pure hues, the 12 colors of the color wheel. I mixed a medium gray and I mixed kind of a light gray because you need to have two of each. So a light tint, a light shade, medium shade, and a light tone and medium tone. So my oranges are kind of transparent. I don't know if you can see that. So I would need to go in and do another coat, which I'm gonna do. Because you don't want the white of the paper to show through, because then it's technically not a nice pure hue. So I'm gonna do that. So I'm gonna mix up orange again. And if you remember when we talked in our Zoom meeting about mixing your secondary colors to get that color, it's not a 50-50 mix of your primaries, because with paint, it's different than digital, where the pigment that's actually in the paint, in some paints it's a lot stronger than in other colors. So for instance, the pigment that makes the yellow is a much stronger pigment than what's in the primary red. So I'm gonna start, or actually that's vice versa. The red is a lot stronger. So I'm gonna start with yellow, and I'm gonna make a decent batch of it because I also don't want to mix up all my colors, so I don't want to get my yellow into my pile of red over here. So wipe your palette knife off. I'm just going to use a little bit of the red. So you can see that's not a 50-50 mix. And it should get you a nice orange. I'm going to mix it really well. Like that, and then use your. You can see it's a little bit on the red side, so I'm gonna add. I put a little too much red in it because now it's going towards the red orange. That's okay. Red orange is actually a tertiary color, so but that's a nice good orange right there. I'm gonna use this. You can mix up more. Obviously, I'm just doing a little bit for demonstration purposes, but feel free to mix up more than that. It will definitely get you further. And I'm using a small 1/4 inch flat brush to lay in my paint. And you'll notice here when you look at the color wheel and you flip it over and I go to my orange, that's a light tint. That's a dark, it's kind of a medium. Shade, and then this is a light tone, kind of all on the light sides. So you can really study your color wheel to see how they should pretty much look. I'm just gonna lay this in here. And I'm laying the paint down instead of going like this and dabbing at it. So it lays it down more smoothly. And you can go in two different directions. So now it's starting to get a little more opaque where the white's not coming through. Okay, so now I want to do my tints. And again, they're transparent. So all you're going to do for tints is add a little bit of white. So I can use this pile. And there's two ways that you can do this. You can start with part of it, grab some white. You can mix it with your brush. If you want, since this is just, you're just doing a couple swatches, you're not doing a whole bunch. Just make sure it's mixed really good. So you can do it like this. Go in my light section and lay it down. And then if I want to do a little bit more, a little bit less of the white. So typically you would start with the lighter and then, or maybe darker and go lighter. So you add more and more white. Just want it tinted a little bit. But you can kind of see mixing with the brush, it's not as easy. If you're gonna use your palette knife, you have to constantly clean it off so you're not mixing new colors into it. And so I have like a medium and a light tint. Okay. Now for the shade. Clean brushes are definitely key. I have a lot of orange here. I'm gonna grab a little bit of orange and you're gonna see adding barely any black, just like a tiny, tiny, tiny bit on my brush is gonna make this orange really dark really fast. The black is really strong. So I'm gonna stick that orange over there. Add a little bit more. And that's gonna be my darker shade. You can see it has a totally different look. You know, it's kind of more brownish. And the darker the color, the more transparent. Also, I have a little bit of water on there on my brush, which you don't want. Running out of orange. Okay. It's really hard. Orange is kind of going towards a medium value color, so any bit of black that you add, it's really gonna change it quickly, so. And remember, it's just the pure orange. You're not doing, don't grab from your tints. I probably should have mixed up more orange, but that's okay. It's not the prettiest color, but all right, I'm gonna mix up more orange because that was not enough. Hello. And you can start to see why this size is pretty good for the amount of paint that you go through. It's not highly pigmented. The paint that's in the tubes has a higher amount of pigment. So some of you might want to use those paints instead. It goes a little bit further. One thing that you could do, oh, I'll hold that thought. So black, I'm using ivory black. It's a cooler black. Mars black is a warmer black. So ivory black has a bluish color to it. So when you obviously mix that with anything that has yellow in it, it's gonna have a greenish tinge to it. It'll be a warm green because the yellow is very warm and the red is pretty warm, but it's still pretty greenish. So you'll be able to see that when you start laying down your paint. Okay, so I'm gonna do two tones. I'm gonna do a light one, kind of a light one, using my pure orange. I'm just going to grab a little bit. This could be close to a 50-50 mix if you like. And you can already see it's looking pretty green. Well, hopefully you can see it. My lighting's not the greatest right now. But on there you can really see it's very green. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to grab my pure orange again, and I'm going to do the medium gray. Not using a lot of it. You can play with it. You could do a 50-50. You could try using more orange and just a little bit of the gray to tone it down just a little. Because when you do the 50-50, it looks a lot more green. I'm gonna try one where it's mostly the orange and just a little bit of gray. So just a dab of it, just to tone that bright saturation down. Just do it over here. Too much water on my brush. I'm one of those painters, I often mix with my brushes. Probably not always the best idea, but it's still pretty green, but it's a little fresher of a color. So those are your oranges. Since I have been working with orange, I could technically go straight over to the tertiary and work with red orange, which I'm gonna do to show you that. So if I have my orange all mixed up here already, I'm gonna grab some more yellow. And now I need to get, I'll use a little bit more of the red. To try and match that yellow. Or the red orange, not orange. So it should be, you got the yellow, you have the red, it should be something kind of halfway in between those two. So that's why it's good since you have it already out here mixed up, you can just push it to the reds now. And that looks about right. When you're mixing bigger batches like this, I would definitely suggest a palette knife. If you don't have a palette knife, maybe use a separate brush. All right. So again, over here, I'm gonna do the same thing, same order. Again, it's laying down pretty transparent. So I would need to go back into it. So I'm gonna save some, make sure I don't mess it up, and do another coat. But for now, I'm going to grab some and I'm gonna do my tints. Behave, and I'm gonna use my palette knife. So you're gonna maybe go through a lot of paper towel, but if you are conserving on paper towel right now, then that might be an issue. So for this, I think the easiest way to do two different tints and shades and stuff is, at least for the tints, one of them could be maybe 25% white, 75% the color, and then maybe one that's 50-50. And I didn't correct my lines. Someone pointed out there's only three secondaries and six tertiaries. I didn't catch it till later, so I'll fix it. Okay. So obviously you can do any order. You can put your colors in any order that you want. You can be more creative with your layout. This is just for demonstration. You can do that however you like. So I have my two tints. And now I'm going to go back to my red orange. I'm gonna find a place to work. Split that up because that's too much. Once you start using your darker, medium to darker colors, you sure don't need a lot of black. Barely put anything in there. And this is gonna look very similar to the oranges. Acrylics dry pretty quick. They do dry darker than what you first lay down, which makes them very different from like oil paints. You can use a blow dryer to dry them. That one's looking way too red orange. I don't like it. I'm gonna fix my orange over there. Ignore this part. So the key is just having your one good thing is just have your color wheel out in front of you so that you can see what you're doing. Because if, say, like I have a situation going on here where my orange and my red orange look too similar. So if that's happening, you need to make adjustments in one of them. So the easiest way to do that is use your color wheel and see that orange is okay. That's not red enough, which I should have checked that in the beginning. So just definitely want to have your color wheel out while you're mixing for this project. That's more red orange. Okay, let's do this again. Because that's still really wet. It looks a little lighter than it's going to right now. Because remember, it dries darker. I'm gonna redo my tint. It's a little more salmon color, which is what you want. That's better. So if you notice how I had the one mixture with a tiny bit of black, and I use that, and then I want more of the color to show through, just grab more from your pure color and add to it instead of mixing a new batch. need tones. So got this over here. Over here, I'm gonna start with my lighter gray. I'm not gonna use a lot. That was kind of 50-50. That's my sister getting home, banging the door. I'm gonna go a little bit darker. Okay, so that's your orange and your red orange. So I have this palette with all these colors, right? And I need to go into a different mixture. So what do? A, you want probably clean water. You could scrape off some of your paint. Let's see if I have a X-Acto blade anywhere. You can cut away first. You want to make sure you've gone in with your second coats before you do anything. So I have my light tint over here for my orange. I'll do that first. Then I have my medium tint. I'm going to use up this paint. And I have my tone, light tone color. And you can see on the brush, it's a little bit lighter than how it dried. I'll give you an idea of how it dries. I'm gonna scoop up some of my darker tone. And you can see now it's nice, clean, pure color. And that's what you want. You don't want streaky. Okay. And I've got, oops, I did not want that. Shoot. I want my orange. I'm going over here for more orange. If you need to get back to orange, just grab some of your yellow and pretty wet. All right, so I want to keep my grays. I want to keep my colors. So depending on how you're working, if you're working with paper plates, you could pour out your colors, your primaries and your black and white on one plate, and then have a separate one for mixing so that when you go to your next thing, you could just take the foil up, toss it, put out a new one. If you're working with a tray, like the one I have here. I was working with this yesterday. You could just wipe it out in the middle. And if you have a paper palette, easiest way, this is what I do when I'm painting. Because I'll have, typically all of my colors all the way around. And then I'll be working in the middle. Okay, so I'm gonna use where am I going here? I'm gonna do green, okay? So same thing as the orange, green, start with yellow. Mix up a decent batch of it and just a little bit of the blue. It's like cooking. When you season, you can add, but you can't subtract. I mean, I guess technically you could add more yellow, but you can see how fast, how dark that makes that. See if it works. If it's a good color. That's my green. Looks good to me. Okay. Mix it really good. That is your pure green that you're gonna use. You can lay it in thick if you want to. You don't have to do second coat necessarily. Okay. And now the tints, same thing. So just grab some of your green. Split it, maybe do one 50-50. Or you could go more white, less green to go lighter. It's up to you. Okay. And for this one, I'm gonna go a little bit lighter. So, okay, here's a situation where if I want to go lighter than this, I can just add right to that. To get a lighter value. If I wanted go even lighter, so I would just add more and more white to go lighter and lighter. Okay. So I got to like a really, really nice. I'm just gonna kind of go all over. For this one, if I want to just do a little bit of a tint. So basically you could start like less white for just a slight tint and just gradually add white to go lighter. This is gonna be darker. Okay. So shades, you wanna make sure you definitely clean off your palette knife and your brush. Because you don't want, when you're doing shades, you don't want white mixed in to your black and your color, because then you're dealing with a tone and not a pure tint or a pure shade. So I'm gonna leave that alone and bring my green over. Tiny bit of black. Too much water on my brush. Really kind of let the paper towel soak that up. Go back over it. Okay. Now a little bit more. It's usually better to mix up a little bit more paint, not real thin, because then it will be easier to lay down and get your color. That went dark really fast. But it's still greenish. So I would go in and do a second coat on that when it was dry. And let's do a tone. Over here. The minute that white comes in, it automatically makes it more opaque. So it's less see-through, less transparent. I probably didn't need to mix up that much gray because I'm not really using very much of it. So again, same thing with the tertiary. If I have the greens out and now I'm working with blue, I could go for either the yellow green or I can go with the blue green. It's up to you. So that would just be mixing a primary with the secondary. So whatever you have mixed up, I have the green mixed up. I would probably do obviously more than that. I could go either way. I could do the yellow green here and then I could do blue green underneath it. I don't care if these are in order because I'll be able to tell, you know, what's what. So that's that. So I want to actually do really quick, because one of the problems that my students face is mixing up violet. It ends up being too red because a lot of times I'll start with the red and then add blue and then it's because it's not a 50-50 thing, and I'll just show you. So if I start with blue, and I just add a little bit of red, just gonna grab it, and don't do that with your brush because you're gonna dirty up your pile. This is like a blue violet. So you may go kind of 50-50 with it, but you can see it's really dark. Like really dark, really dark. Okay, that's okay. So you can see if I went transparent with it, you can see that it's violet, right? The violet is pretty dark. So it's gonna be maybe, it actually is pretty close to 50-50 there. And I'll show you really quick, when you start adding white to it, you get those really pretty violets. If you start with, if you get too much red, it doesn't work. So if you're using just the primary red and the primary blue, you get a nice violet. But the trade-off is you get much cooler reds than, you know, kind of what show here. Well, it's pretty close. It's not bad. It's a little bit cooler than here. If you use a cadmium, that's a much warmer red. You're going to get a color that's more like eggplant, not violet. It's okay. It's still a beautiful color. So I'm just going to start adding white. And you can see... here's my tint, one tint, dark tint. So if I flip this over, they have a light tint, so I'm gonna add more white. This is kind of in between the blue violet and the violet right now. So you may need to add a touch more red than what I did. So again, have your color wheel out so you can make your comparisons. It'll make life much easier as you do this. You can see my paper towel is all kind of scary looking. But that's the gist of it. The tertiary is, you know, it's just a little more mixing, but it's easy to do it when you work with the colors that are out there and then fan out. So if I have my secondary color mixed, then all I have to do is add one of the primaries to that color to get one of the tertiaries and do your tints and shades. And if you lay everything out, it goes pretty fast. This is something you could do in a few hours, probably maybe half a day. It shouldn't really take you much longer than that. And that's about it. That's all I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna do the whole thing. So, because I wanna erase these lines and spread them out a little bit more. Have fun.